Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Autumn is an interesting season. Wait, what? It's that time already? Oh, I guess it is. Yep, on September 22nd at 2044 UTC, Earth reaches autumnal equinox for the Northern Hemisphere. What's fascinating about autumn for astronomy is we get some extra time to view some of the summer sights. Let's look west. Note where the three stars of the summer triangle are at midnight on September 22nd. But because days get shorter and nights get longer, let's fast forward to the winter solstice, December 21st at 6 p.m. All three stars have only dropped about 10 degrees towards the west. So even though there's quite a time difference, the summer triangle is still visible at the beginning of winter, or the end of autumn. But many of us lose all the wonderful clusters and nebula of Sagittarius and Scorpius in the south, replaced by Pisces Austrinus, which only offers the first magnitude star Fomalhaut as a beacon in that part of the sky. Between the summer triangle and there are the somewhat dimmer constellations of Capricornus and Aquarius, both part of the water constellations, like Pisces Austrinus also is. These two constellation names may sound familiar, as they are part of the zodiac since the ecliptic runs through them, and we can find Neptune in Aquarius and Uranus in the dim Pisces the fish to its east. Cetus the whale, or sea monster, rounds out most of the large, mostly dim, water-themed constellations here. And now this week's dark sky fact. In the United States alone, $2.2 billion is wasted on light that doesn't even light up the ground. Use lower wattage lighting that is aimed and shielded at the ground so we can save money and still see at night, including the stars overhead. Rising in the east and moving towards overhead, we find somewhat brighter second magnitude stars, and many of these can be found by knowing how to measure 15 degrees in the sky, and estimating 20 degrees from that. Pegasus the flying horse is one of the more obvious ones, the flying horse's wings forming a near-perfect square, or diamond, in the sky, as its stars are almost perfectly 15 degrees per side. Off the western side of this foursome is Enif, the nose of the horse, at 20 degrees away. On the opposite side are the stars of Andromeda the princess, and the stars Myrac and Almac are nearly a perfect 15 degrees from the square. Continue another 15 degrees in the same direction, and we run right into the star Mirfak in Perseus the Hero. Rising near the horizon, if we follow somewhat along that same line, is Capella, one of the brightest stars in the sky, in the constellation Auriga. Now, if we double that 15 degrees at 30, and we find the orangish Aldebaran in Taurus towards the south, with the lovely Pleiades 15 degrees away, which precede the red giant across the sky. And rounding out the autumn sky to the north are Cassiopeia the queen and Cepheus the king. The distinctive W shape of the queen is hard to miss about 20 degrees to the northwest of Mirfak and Perseus, though look for Cassiopeia on her side, or perhaps a bit more M-shaped at this time of year. Cepheus is dimmer, looking like an upside-down house shape. We'll explore many of these stars and constellations over the next 3 months, so now is a great time to get familiar with where to find all of them. With the moon full on the 19th, many deep sky objects will be challenging to observe easily. But the first, second, and third magnitude stars of these shapes shouldn't be too hard to find. As we wave goodbye to useful evening telescopic observations of Saturn for the year, Venus makes one last stop by the planet this week. Meanwhile, Jupiter reaches a useful observing altitude by 2 or 3 a.m. in the morning, with the still small Mars following it about 2 hours later. That leaves the evening sky largely devoid of bright planets, Neptune angling across Aquarius and Uranus puttering past Pisces, while the moon cruelly makes it difficult to see either one over the next 7 days. And that's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.